When she was 3 years old, Madeleine McCann vanished into thin air. The little British girl disappeared from her family's hotel room in Portugal in 2007. The confounding incident has since become the most heavily reported missing person case in modern history. There were no signs of forced entry or any rational explanation as to how it happened. Over the following weeks, theories ranged from an abduction by a stranger to Madeleine's own parents covering up her accidental death. A child sex trafficking ring also entered the discussion. 4 months after her disappearance, the Portuguese police classified her parents Kate and Jerry McCann as formal suspects. However, that designation was later lifted due to lack of evidence. The incident soon became international in scope, with authorities and publishers from around the world entering the fray and offering opinions. Scotland Yard opened its own inquiry in 2011, while the Portuguese police continued to explore new theories. In the meantime, the British media spectacle surrounding this story was paralleled only by the death of Princess Diana. Even the Tottenham Hotspurs got involved by wearing Madeleine McCann t-shirts before a major soccer game. Some people, among them former detectives, have called the case unsolvable as recently as January 2020. Too much time has elapsed. There are too many holes in too many stories. Crucial CCTV cameras were strangely not turned on when they normally should have been. In 2007, Kate and Jerry McCann took their children, 3-year-old Madeleine and her 2-year-old twin siblings, on vacation at a resort in Praia da Luz, Beach of Light, in Portugal. The apartment they rented was on the ground floor. Madeleine McCann vanished from that very room on the night of May 3, 2007. When her parents left to have dinner with friends at a tapas restaurant at 8:30 p.m., they left the girl and her siblings in the room as they slept. It was only later that the McCanns recalled Maddie asking over breakfast that morning, "Why didn't you come when my brother and I cried last night?" This led them to believe that someone uninvited may have been in the room perhaps more than once. With the restaurant being so close to the apartment, the McCanns checked on their kids throughout dinner. It was 10 p.m. when Kate McCann noticed her daughter was missing. From that point on, their lives would never be the same. Madeleine hasn't been seen since. One of the first suspects in Madeleine's disappearance was a 33-year-old man named Robert Marat. The British-Portuguese real estate consultant lived near the McCann's apartment. And around 9:15 p.m. that night, a man had been seen walking in the direction of Marat's home carrying a child. Of course, at the time, nobody knew Madeleine was even missing, or that the child being carried might have been her. As it turned out, no solid evidence linked Marat to the case, and his status as a suspect was later lifted. 4 months after Madeleine's disappearance, Portuguese police added Madeleine's parents to their list of arguidos, or suspects. Some cops believe the girl had died in their apartment and that the supposed child abduction was entirely fabricated to cover up her death. While that might sound pretty harsh to parents whose child had been lost for a distressing amount of time, authorities did have their reasons to consider them as possible suspects. Apparently, two sniffer dogs had been brought to the scene by British police in July 2007. One canine was trained specifically to detect human blood, the other, the scent of dead bodies. The animals were walked through numerous locations, but only alerted their officers inside the family's apartment and while inside the Renault Scenic hire car that the McCanns rented 24 days after their daughter went missing. Authorities thus theorized that Jerry and Kate McCann may have hidden their daughter's corpse, faked the abduction, and placed the body into the car weeks later. With the body yet to be discovered, police believe the two adults concealed the corpse in an undetermined location. As for the motive behind this cold-blooded act the McCanns were being accused of, it was quite mundane, an accident and the consequent fear of prison. The theory argues that Jerry and Kate McCann, who were both doctors, gave their daughter too much sedative to sleep. While a seemingly harmless solution to garnering an uninterrupted dinner with adults, the medication supposedly killed Madeleine, leaving her terrified parents desperate to stay out of jail. Ultimately, it was a hair and fiber analysis from the car in the apartment that led authorities to label the parents as suspects. However, sniffer dog evidence is rarely airtight. One U.S. court case saw a judge agree with analysis of three dogs' performances that found they were incorrect 78%, 71%, and 62% of the time. The DNA analysis, however, was a little more convincing. John Lowe of the UK's Forensic Science Service, FSS, said 15 out of 19 components of Madeleine's DNA profile were found in the hire car. Nonetheless, this still came with caveats large enough to offer some reasonable doubt. It's important to stress that 50% of Madeleine's profile will be shared with each parent, he said. It is not possible, in a mixture of more than two people, to determine or evaluate which specific DNA components pair with each other. Therefore, we cannot answer the question, is the match genuine, or is it a chance match? Kate and Jerry McCann had their suspect status removed in July 2008. They described the early suspicion of them as ludicrous. Meanwhile, they still hold out hope to this day, nearly 13 years after the disappearance, that Madeleine might someday be found. One theory centers on a potential burglary gone wrong. Madeleine is said to have been abducted after waking up and witnessing the crime. Scotland Yard hasn't ruled this out, but it's also likely that such a scenario would have robbers acting in panic and thus leaving obvious clues behind. Nonetheless, Police did identify four Prayadalu's locals who seemed to fit that bill. Their locations at the time of the child's disappearance did seem to fit a burglary pattern. The men were questioned in 2014, but released when Scotland Yard found no concrete evidence against them. Former head of the Police Judiciary Officers Union Carlos Anjos never considered this a valid hypothesis in the first place. "This burglary theory is absurd," he said. "Not even a wallet disappeared, no television disappeared, nothing else disappeared. A child disappeared." Another theory claims Madeleine was abducted by a local pedophile. Reports in 2009 found the region had been awash with pedophiles at the time of her disappearance. One source says at the time, there are 38 known sex offenders in the Algarve. The area is a magnet for pedophiles. The source continued, there have been 7 sexual assaults involving children of tourists in the Algarve in the last 4 years. They all have the same modus operandi as Madeleine's disappearance, that is, a break-in at a holiday apartment and children molested. 5 happened before Madeleine's abduction, and 2 afterwards. One took place a month before she vanished. Oddly enough, former MP Sir Clement Freud, who had a holiday home there and knew the McCanns, was later outed as a pedophile. One of his former victims said she felt uneasy when she realized he knew Madeleine's parents. Nobody else would have thought Freud capable of abuse and rape, but he did it to me. Nonetheless, investigators pointed out that pedophiles rarely risk breaking into a home to get to a child.